मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू SST एज वी हैव स्टार्टेड द सिविक्स चैप्टर 2 एंड जस्ट क्विकली रिकॉल वॉट एवर वी हैव डन इन पार्ट 2 वीडियो. सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इन डिटेल अबाउट द शेड्यूल कास्ट पीपल्स एंड हाउ द गवर्नमेंट एज नॉट गवर्नमेंट हाउ द पीपल यूज टू behave with the scheduled caste people, who was Dalit and whatever the facilities and that has been actually not given to Dalit because of caste system. And always the caste people used to feel, the higher caste class caste people used to feel superior than the lower class, and lower class always used to feel very broken. And they were actually abandoned from their rights to utilize the water and utilize the resources the way the higher class people used to use. So today we are going to proceed with Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar journey, which I have asked you to even Google search who was he. I hope you have done it. So he is actually the father of constitution. He has written the constitution of India. Constitution of India means the written document of law and order of the country. As you know that why it is important to have law and order in our country. Suppose for an example, why do you feel that school needs to have rules and regulation? Otherwise what will happen if we are not having some rules of how to be disciplined in school, how to follow the timetable, how to maintain the silence, how to maintain the respect towards the teacher? Do you feel that it is going to be very okay, that students will feel secure and student will really enjoy the learning? No, because discipline is necessary for each and every phase of life. That is the reason even each and every organization and the country needs to have few rules and regulation. Some rules that has to be followed by the citizen, that has to be followed by the staff and employee of the organization. So Dr. Bhimrao, I am in page number 19. The second paragraph of the right side, Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, one of the greatest leader of India, shares his first experience of caste-based discrimination which took place in 1901. Actually, he is the father of our constitution, but he is also belongs to the Dalit group. So as we have discussed, that Dalit means the lower class people, and people used to exploit them, people used to call them untouchable. Untouchable means achhut. So he also faced a lot of issue during his young age and during his childhood, and he has seen so many people discriminating them. So long did we wait, but no one turned up. An hour elapsed and station master came to inquire. He asked us for our ticket. We showed them, that is actually the real story of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. We showed them to him. He asked us, why are we tarried? We told him that we were bound to for the Koregaon and we were waiting for our father to servant to come. And neither had turned up, and we did not know how to reach Koregaon. So Koregaon is a small village which is there in Maharashtra. He belongs to that village. He wanted to go back there. We were well-dressed children. From our dress and talk, obviously, nobody could make out he belongs to the lower class Dalit group. So as usual, the Hindus means when it has been found by that they were from that belongs that lower class people. The station master asked that who we were. Without a moment thought, I blurred that we were the Mahars. Now I want you to write a question, who was a Mahar? Answer is from here, last fourth line. Mahar is one of the community which were treated as untouchable in Bombay Presidency. So today's first question is, who was the Mahar? So Mahar, answer is there in the bracket, is one of the community which were treated as untouchable in Bombay Presidency. And actually they were treated as a Dalit of that society. Like people were not allowed to go to utilize the resources, to go for the water, taking water from the village, taking food from the village. That was the so much restrictions were there. We could see that overpowered of the strange feeling of repulsion, as soon he heard my reply, he went away to the room and he stood where we were. 15 to 20 minutes elapsed. Our father had not turned up and he sent the servant. And we were quiet and bewildered, and joy and happiness, which we feel the beginning of the journey, gave the feeling of extreme sadness. Earlier they were very happy to go back to the village, but when they have seen the behavior of the station master after saying that the children belongs to Mahar caste. The station master went back to his room because untouchable means the station master were actually showing that he cannot touch us. He cannot stay near to us. So that feeling of excitement gone to the sadness because of the behavior of the station master. After half an hour, the station master returned and asked the proposal, and he asked that, okay, fine. You far away, straight away, go from here. There were a bullock cart, you hire and go back. Mahars had gone round among the cart men. You are not allowed to go by the train. We were prepared to pay even double the fare of the train, but the station master was not at all ready. Why the station master was not at all ready? Because he was feeling that Mahar class means the untouchable people. How can I give the permission to this group of people to go by train? If they're paying more money, then also we should not allow, because other caste people in the train will definitely object. And they will have an objection, why are you allowing the Mahar class people in the train? Now I want you to focus in the small, passage wherein you can see the picture of Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar. That is considered the father of Indian constitution, is also the best known leader of the Dalit. So the second question, who was, I asked you yesterday to Google search, who was Bhimrao Ambedkar? He was the father of the constitution and he was the leader of the Dalit. Dr. Ambedkar fought for the right of Dalit community. He was born in Mahar caste, were very poor, they were not having the ownership of the land. The parents used to work hard in the village and all, and but still they were facing a lot of issue while struggling with the normal upper class people. Dr. Ambedkar was the first person, I wanted you to pay attention over here, his caste to complete the college education and went to England to become lawyer. He was the first from the Mahar class people who became the lawyer, and he went to England to complete his study. He encouraged Dalit to send their children to school and colleges. He also urged Dalit to take in different kinds of government job in order to move out the caste system. He led many efforts to Dalit to gain entry into temples. Later on, converted Buddhism in search of religion treated. And he believed that Dalit must have fight for the caste system, work towards a society based on respect. So when he has himself, just where the story we have read about the feeling that he has felt when he wanted to go to the village and because of the station master, he couldn't go by the train. So after that, the life has changed for him and he has decided whatever is going to happen, I am going to fight for my caste, that is Mahar caste, that is Dalit. And the first thing he always used to urge to his group, that without fail you are supposed to fight for your rights. Without fail you should go for higher education, because if you are educated, if you can confront yourself in front of people and society, nobody can actually ask you to go away. Because I believe that कि अगर हम पढ़े लिखे हैं तो कोई हमें ऐसा नहीं बोलेगा कि आप अछूत हो, आप कोई भी काम नहीं कर सकते हो, आप बात नहीं कर सकते हो. तो when you are actually being educated, then automatically your respect is going to be increased in the society. That was his belief. And actually that really worked for everyone. And he himself done a lot of thing for his community. He has urged the society to try to be equal towards the Dalit people, try to be respectful towards them. Even he asked the Dalit people, just raise your voice whenever you are feeling discriminated because of the higher class people. Now we are proceeding to the next page, wherein we are going to talk about striving for equality. Now as we are talking about the Dalit people and the way Dalit people used to discriminate because of the higher class, what is the meaning of striving? Striving means when you are ready to fight for your right. Right, right means fundamental right. Right means your aapka jo hak hai ki hame jeena hai, hame bhi apna adhikar chahiye. Now I wanted to focus in this small paragraph of striving for equality. The struggle of freedom, British rule. You all are aware that British ruled India for so many years, and we have struggled to get the freedom from them. And this large group of people who are not only fought against the British but also fought to get treated equally. Dalit women tribal and the peasant fought against the inequality and experience in their life because they were also getting struggled with the because of the British people. And you will learn a lot in history in 8th standard about what are the struggle they have faced during the British rule. As pointed out earlier, many Dalit organizations themselves took an entry into temples. Women demanded that yes, there should be the right for education for the man and the woman as well. Peasants and tribal fought to release themselves from the grasp. Peasants mean the farmer, the poor farmer. Tribal, I already have discussed, the people, those who belongs to the nature, they love nature, they always in a staying in a group, they do not want to stay in the society where other people are staying. So these people used to have started the raising their voice against the equality. When India became a nation in 1947, leaders were concerned about the kinds of inequality because it has been already established in the society, because Britishers used to treat these lower class people very badly, the tribal people very badly. Those who has written the Constitution of India, the nation would function wherein the awareness of crime and the equality should be there and legally abolished by the law. So they were concerned when Bhimrao Ambedkar have started writing the constitution, and the other leader like Gandhiji, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru were there also. Their concern was that right now this is a high time to give the equality to the Dalit group. People are free to choose the kind of work and the government jobs in the constitution, and constitution also placed responsibility in the government to take specific steps to realize that the right of equality to poor is such a marginal community which is needed. Marginal community means, margin means there is a border wherein we cannot cross, and this marginal community means the people like Dalit and the tribal, they have a different community background, they do not want to cross the limit and go and try to mix with the other society people. They were very much happy with their community, but Britishers used to trouble them a lot and actually took away their rights also to live properly in their own way of life. And when this Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar and Jawaharlal Nehru, they were struggling with the constitution, they have already decided whatever is going to happen, we are going to give the equal rights to the Dalit group as well as to the lower class people. They felt that people must have the freedom to follow their own religion, speak their language, celebrate their festival and express themselves. They said that no one language, religion or festival should become the compulsory to follow. They said their government must treat all religion equally. I wanted you to understand the whole paragraph, which is very, very important for all of us. When constitution has been written for all of us, on that moment, the famous leaders like Gandhiji, Jawaharlal Nehru, Bhimrao Ambedkar and all, they were struggling to make India is as such a country that everybody should be united. Because in the initial lecture, we have discussed that diversity means a differences in opinion, a differences in culture and religion, the way of life and everything. But in India, because of this constitution, because constitution is giving the right to live, freedom, fundamental right, yani ki hame haq hai, hum koi bhi religion ko maan sakte, hum koi bhi religion ke festival ko mana sakte, nobody can ask that being a Hindu, why are you celebrating it? Being a Muslim, why are you celebrating Diwali? Nobody is going to question. Because here I wanted you to pay attention that India is a secular nation. Secular nation means free to choose and free to follow the religion wherever you are having belief in. So nobody is going to say that okay, you are belongs to Hindu, you should follow Hindu only. If they wanted to change their religion in Christian or Muslim, they can do. Nobody is going to question. That is a fundamental right of every citizen. So government has given this kind of power to give the equality, to give the fundamental right. Should people should not be feeling that they are discriminating and they are being actually pressurized. One more thing I wanted you to focus, that India became the secular country. That is, if the question comes, what is the meaning of secular country? The answer is just the paragraph which I have asked you to remember. This is very important. Answer is from here. They felt that, instead of they, you are supposed to write, the leaders, the nationalist leaders felt that people must have freedom to follow their religion, their festival and express themselves freely, which means India is a secular country. Again, I repeat my question. The question is, what is the meaning of secular country? Or how can we say that India is a secular country? That is the better question. How can we say that India is a secular country? The answer is, the national leaders felt that, it is just above this paragraph, felt that people must have freedom to follow their religion, speak their language, celebrate their festival and express themselves freely. So, India is a secular country. I hope you have written the question and answer. The answer even is there in the PDF format of question answer, which I will be sending along with this video. Now, I just wanted to say a few things, last thing about the chapter. So, the leader set out the last paragraph. So, the leader set out the vision and the goal and the constitution to ensure that people of India were considered equal. What is the meaning of vision? Vision means a goal to be achieved. For an example, right now you are studying in 6th standard. You must have thought ke bade hoke main doctor banu, engineer banu, ya fir main teacher banu. Whatever your vision is, that is actually called vision. Okay? Future mein aapko kya karna hai? So in constitution, when they were framing it, they have already a vision ke in future we are supposed to, I am supposed to have an equal nation wherein everybody is facing free mindset and they are free to follow whatever they wish to. The equality of all person is seen as a key value and everyone has equal rights and opportunities and untouchability is seen. The freedom to practice and follow the religion without any fear, and this is seen important element of the unity. So what is the important element of the constitution? That everybody can practice any religion without any fear. Again, I repeat my question. I wanted to write, what is the key element of the unity of the country? That each and every answer is, each and every one can follow the religion without having any fear or discrimination from others. Though other ideals also enrich that, and equality is a value to have a striving for, and people struggle to get this equality. So I would like to conclude here my third part, and including that I will be posting the PPT as well as question answers of PDF. I wanted you to write the question answers in the notebook, because when we are going to open the school, the notebook checking is going to start. So in this chapter, the conclusion was, what are the things we have learned? We have learned what is the meaning of diversity, what is the meaning of discrimination, what is the meaning of Dalit. What is the, who is the famous Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, why he has been so, what are the things he has done for the nation, and why India is called a secular country, and what is the meaning of prejudice, what is the meaning of stereotype. So these are the important points I wanted you to focus, which is there in the PDF format. So definitely you will be getting all the question answers, even the objective and subjective both. So I wanted to practice those question answers. Any doubt, please do mention and write down in your notebook. When we will meet, I'll clarify the doubt along with you. So take care of yourself. I'll meet you soon with another chapter. I hope all of you are enjoying it. Please study well, be safe, and enjoy learning. Thank you. Bye.